Welcome back. So as we're all getting pretty used to video conferencing, working from home now in these troubled times, the IT user who's using Zoom, Google Hangouts, Microsoft Teams will notice that some of your colleagues are using filters, embellishments, to make their image look either a little bit more streamlined with filters, a little bit zany, or different backgrounds. Let's talk about different backgrounds, and we're going to do this using Google Hangouts and another piece of software. So we're all typically familiar with Google Hangouts and Google Meet, as it's now being rebranded. So if we typically join and start a meeting, typing in a meeting code, let's join that meeting. We can see my camera starting and we can see the busy background that I've got behind me. Now that might not be conducive to a meeting image that I want to portray. Now you may want to have things like show a corporate background or something else a little bit more less industrial. It's like what I've got going on here. Well, within Google Meet at the moment, there is no change to the background. That's at the moment. We've had conversations with Google lately, and they do say that it is on their Google Meet roadmap. When it's going to come out, we don't really know, but it's going to come out. So what can we do to help embellish what we're doing here with a different background? Well, let's take a look. One option is to use the Snap camera. Okay, if you go to snapcamera.snapchat.com, you're given the option of downloading a third-party piece of software. For all you young millennials out there, Snapcamera or Snapchat will be very familiar to you. Whether it's in trend or not, that's a different conversation. I'm old, so I'm coming to this party and I think things are great. As you can see from the playing video that we've got on the screen in front of us, you can put different embellishments upon yourself to create a different avatar. Typically what you do here, you click on download, you read the license agreement, which I would encourage you to do, you make sure your machine is of the correct specification, so that's at least operating system of Windows 7, SP1 64-bit or newer. If you're using the fruit, then macOS 10.12 or newer, and a minimum of Intel Core i3 2.5 GHz with 4 GB of RAM, and you need a decent graphics card as well. An Intel HD Graphics 4000, GeForce 710, or a HD Radeon 6450 with a resolution of 1280 by 768 or higher. Well, that's the tech spec, because I've had some people on other videos saying, oh, it doesn't work. Well, if your machine's not up to it, it's not going to work, or you're going to have a bit of a degraded image. Read through the license agreement. Make sure you're happy with it. If you are, click on the button, type in your email address, tell them that you're not a robot, and download it for PC. Okay? No worries. So I've already got this downloaded and installed. Pointless going through the install process. It's literally next, 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 install, away you go. You can access the software by typing in Snap for Snap Camera, and that brings up the interface. Here you can see I've now got an update to install. So let's go ahead and install that update. A whole 88 megabytes. We'll be back. So now with the update installed, you can see I've got the Snap Camera interface. Now with this interface, let's enlarge it to full screen. You can see here's my live feed from my camera at the top. And then you can put in different filters. And you can see it's turning my face into liquid gold. There's plenty of work from home ones. Make myself into a hologram. It's quite good with the green screen background. I do like that. You know, the options for this are limitless. Make yourself into a potato, that quintessential thing. And then when you go, you set your filter, you can then go into Google Hangouts. Let's start or join a meeting. Let's call it meeting one. Okay. The camera failed because there's already a codec joining. Let's join that here. Here we go. You see, the camera won't work simply because we've got Snapchat working. So let's close that down. Turn that off. Go upstairs, appear to settings. We change our video. Away from Microsoft Live Camera, we select Snap Camera. Set your definition, click Done. Start your video. And here I am in Google Hangouts as a potato. That might be your thing. Some of these filters can be quite distracting. There are cute ones. Make yourself into a cloud. Or there's some quite, I think, topical ones as well. Make sure you've got a mask on your face. Up to you if you want to use it. It could give a little bit of enjoyment to boring meetings. Make yourself into a cowboy with that big, desperate Dan thick jaw. Completely up to you. But that's how you use Snapcam and Google Meet, formerly Google Hangouts. Dead easy. Make sure you remember, if you're using it on a works PC, that you're not contravening any of your IT department's policies. That the other people on the calls are all right with it. It can be distracting, is a bit of fun, but it's not appropriate for everything. You'll have to install the Snapcam version of the software and also change your settings, as we demonstrated here as well. Okay, so I have been Ricardo. Thanks very much for watching. Speak to you soon.